Welcome to this week's episode of the DevOps Lab. I'm April Edwards, and this week we're going to be talking about Bicep, some of the features, and where you can learn more about how to use Bicep. And this week we're welcoming John Downs onto the show. So stay tuned. Welcome back, everyone, to this episode of the DevOps Lab. I'm April Edwards, and with me, I have a really awesome guest, John Downs. Welcome, John.
Thanks, April.
Really excited to have you here this week. So this week, we're going to talk about Bicep and some really cool things. So tell me, what do you do at Microsoft?
So I'm an engineer in Microsoft Azure, but I don't work on the products directly. I work with customers who are deploying solutions to Azure. So I help customers to architect solutions and to understand how to use Azure services for what they're trying to do.
Cool. Well, I understand you're going to tell us about Bicep today. So Bicep's kind of been a lot of talk around it, and there's a lot going on. So tell us about Bicep.
Yeah, Bicep is the new language for doing infrastructure as code on Azure. So it's a project that the Azure Resource Manager team kicked off, I think, about a year ago. And since then, it's picked up a lot of momentum in the community. Before Bicep, the way to do infrastructure as code with Azure natively was to use ARM templates, which were JSON files. And anybody who's ever touched those know that they're not the nicest things to work with. So Bicep really dramatically improves the way that we can do infrastructure as code with Azure.
Cool. I think the community is really excited to hear about it. Could you kind of go over some of the features and capabilities that Bicep has that kind of sets it apart from ARM templates? Because I think everyone is, you know, ready to move on and really excited about Bicep.
So Bicep, firstly, it actually compiles or transpiles into ARM templates. So all the same features that you've got in ARM templates, you can use in Bicep. But what it really makes is, what it really gives you is a really nice experience to declare and to define your infrastructure in Azure. So it's a much, much nicer experience to write Bicep code than it is to write JSON ARM templates.
And I would agree.
Yeah, cool. definitely. I don't think there's much controversy about that in the community either. There's a whole lot of because it's such a nice experience. I think one of the things that we've been able to really help customers to do is to start to understand how to do more interesting, more complex, more complete deployments because the barrier to entry is so low. So Bicep exposes a lot of the power of Azure without having to go through a lot of hoops.
Cool. And I think one of the cool things you said it, because it's kind of based off like the ARM templates, is there day zero support for all Azure resources?
Absolutely. Yeah. So day zero support is a huge one. And you know, as I said, everything that you can do in ARM templates, you can do in Bicep as well. And then there's also a bunch of features that are part of Azure Resource Manager generally that allow you to do all sorts of other things too. So for example, deployment scripts, which you can use in Bicep too. If there's something you can't actually achieve in Bicep code directly for some reason, then you can use a deployment script to work around that as well. Awesome. And then also things like loops and conditions and a whole bunch of more complex kind of control flow type work that you often need to do with infrastructure as code. Bicep really makes that really, really easy to do.
Cool. Can you give us kind of a demo of some of the Bicep features that are out there that's currently available?
Yeah, absolutely. So I'm going to just do a quick demo of creating a fairly simple scenario, but one that kind of illustrates a lot of the power of Bicep really nicely. So one of the big things about Bicep is the tooling support is really, really good as well. Bicep has an extension for Visual Studio Code, and the Bicep team have done a really fantastic job at making that really, really powerful and easy to use. So I've just opened up a brand new Bicep file here. So I'm on my keyboard, you might see this, but I'm pressing Control Space, which pops up a bunch of snippets. And so these are built-in kind of predefined resource definitions for a whole bunch of very common scenarios so that you can very quickly start building Bicep files. So if I start typing storage and then press Enter, then it pre-populates the definition for a storage account. Awesome. And you can see here there's the syntax for declaring it feels very natural. You know, it's a very easy to read and doesn't have nearly as many curly braces and commas and things as JSON.
And the curly braces and the commas used to kill me in ARM template. And I'd bang my head against the wall repeatedly. But the thing I like is the fact that we can kind of search and get that storage account resource really easily. Because again, syntax matters every time. And that's what kills us. It's a space, it's a comma, curly bracket. So that's awesome. That's so cool.
Yeah. And so then as you start to actually work on real Bicep templates, and as they start to get more complicated, then some of the other tooling features start to kick in as well. So for example, in this case, the snippet just gives you a kind of predefined resource with a name that's hard coded to name. So I'm going to change that. I'm going to make a parameter called storage account name. And I'm going to say it's a string. All right. So you can already see if you've worked with JSON templates, this is a much nicer way of declaring parameters.
Much cleaner.
And then I can also do string interpolation. So if you're used to other programming languages, this is a common feature, but it's something we haven't had in ARM templates before. Mm-hmm. And I can, so I can say, for example, I want to get a unique string for this resource group ID, mm-hmm. and I want to append the word store to the front. So this will basically give me a name that should be unique for my storage account.
Awesome.
So that's, you know, and these kinds of functions and things, that there's really powerful functionality built into Bicep that it exposes. And then you can also see as we're typing that there's these red squigglies and yellow squigglies that appear underneath mm-hmm. our code. So the yellow squigglies run what's called the Bicep linter.
Yeah.
So the Bicep linter is basically scanning our code as we write it. And if mm-hmm. it detects anything that we're doing that doesn't look quite right, it'll prompt us. Cool. So in this case, it's telling me that this parameter is declared but never used, mm-hmm. Which is true. So if I've got a large template, I can kind of look for these issues, and I can use this problems list in Visual Studio Code to get a complete list. And then I can go and fix those. So in this case, I'm going to say, well, the storage account name should actually be from that parameter.
Awesome. That's super easy. I really like that, because as your templates, it's great doing a storage account, but as your templates get a lot bigger and more complex, as most kind of our consumers are doing, it's tough, right? It's tough to manage it. That's really cool. That makes it so much easier to kind of understand, read, and get your syntax correct.
Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. So one of the other things that we're doing in Bicep as well is as I said, we're exposing a lot of the power of Azure in ways that have historically been possible to do through infrastructure as code, but a lot of customers haven't done it because it was just so difficult to work with. So for example, when we start working with storage accounts, one common thing that a lot of people want to do is to create blob containers.
Yeah.
And what I want to do here is talk about a couple of features of Bicep that help you to understand how to create those slightly more complex objects like blob containers. Cool. So what if you look at the resource ID for a storage mm-hmm. account, you'll see it's Microsoft.storage, which is what we call mm-hmm. the resource provider, then a slash, and then the resource type, which is storage accounts. Now, when we start working with blob containers, the resource type is actually a little bit longer and a little bit more complex. And so what we can do is we can create this thing called a nested resource inside mm-hmm. a storage account, and I'm going to call it blob service. So blob service is a resource type that Azure creates automatically for you when you create mm-hmm. a storage account. And because we're not actually going to be declaring this ourselves or deploying this ourselves, we use this feature called existing. Okay. And that tells Bicep that this particular resource that we're declaring here is already exists in Azure. We're not trying to create it again, but it lets us access it from within our Bicep code. So we get all of the strong typing and all of the ability to use all the tooling benefits, but without actually redeploying the resource.
That's cool.
And so going to say the name for this is default. And actually, if you noticed, I'll just try that again. The tooling even knows that the name of this object will always be default. So it prompts us for that.
Awesome.
And so now when I'm going to start creating blob containers in a moment, I'm going to use this child resource here, this blob service resource, as the way to do that. So I'm going to create a resource now called a container. And I'm going to make it a Microsoft.storage/storage accounts/blob services/containers. So you can see here that this is starting to get a bit more complex object type. And as I start to declare this, so one thing I need to do here is set a parent. So because this is a nested resource, I need to use this blob service as its parent.
Okay. And cool. So
again, the way to do this in Bicep is to say, well, I've got a storage account mm-hmm. and it's got a child called blob service.
Okay.
So this double colon lets us access this resource here as the parent of this container.
Okay.
And cool. Then I can say I'm going to create a container called container one. So that's now a complete Bicep template that lets us deploy a storage account and a blob container, and mm-hmm. and to do that by using this nested blob service child resource as well in the process.
That's really cool. I think nesting child resources has been something that's been potentially an issue previously. So really cool to see that come out, see it as a feature in Bicep. That's awesome. Really appreciate you showing this. This is super cool. What other kind of resources are there out there for people to learn, get started, et cetera?
Yeah, so my team and I have actually been working on a whole bunch of content for Microsoft Learn to help customers to understand how to use Bicep, not just the basics, but then to take it to the next level and to do a lot of these more complex things and that we've talked about and a whole bunch of others. So on Microsoft Learn, there's two learning paths that have now been published and there's more to come. So the first one covers the kind of the basics of Bicep and the language. And this one, so everything from, you know, why is infrastructure as code a good idea and how does Bicep work, through to building Bicep templates, using things like parameters, which we've just briefly touched on today, conditions and loops, and then also child and extension resources, which we talked about just now, explaining kind of how they work in a lot more detail than I was able to get into here, and going through the syntax in a lot more detail as well. And then more complex scenarios as well, like deploying to subscriptions and management groups and tenants, which is what a lot of customers are starting to do with things like Azure Policy.
Yeah,
absolutely. Yeah. And deployment scripts too. And then in the second learning path, which has only just been published, that covers more of the kind of collaboration features of Bicep and infrastructure as code. So, you know, how to use Git properly with Bicep code, how to structure your Bicep code so that other people on your team can understand how to use it and how to work with it and kind of follow the best practices. And then also features like template specs and what if, which can help you to unlock a lot of power of Azure as well.
Awesome. And I think that's great because we talk a lot about developer best practices, how we start automating things. I think there's some great tutorials there. Thank you so, so much. Absolutely. That's awesome. Cool. Really awesome. We'll put links to the Microsoft Learn resources at the end of the video. And John, thank you so much for coming on today. It's been super awesome, super informative. Really looking forward to using Bicep more in the future and all the things that the team's producing.
Thanks, April.